disclose something because according to this media report, and I think in some other papers, ito lang kasi nakita ko so far, DOJ reverses ruling on Marcelino drug case. Bakit ko sinasabi ito? Bakit ko ito pinopoint out? So ngayon lang to ha. This is dated today. PhilStar, page 12. Reporting na yung dating decision ng DOJ which dismissed the case against Colonel Marcelino reverse. And naka-report pa nga sa dito na of course, initially, the hunting prosecutor recommended the dismissal for insufficiency of evidence. Now, he is being charged again. And there is a quotation here from a certain Chief Superintendent Antonio Gargiola, former chief of AIDG, said the DOJ resolution comes as a relief for the lawmen going after drug offenders. The PNP, anti-illegal drugs group, welcomed the reversal of the DOJ ruling. And there is a quote attributed to Chief Superintendent Antonio Gargiola saying, whoever they are, even active members of the PNP and armed forces and the government, as long as you're involved in drugs, they should be caught, certainly. And then Chief Inspector Roque Merdia, former chief of the AIDG, said they are hoping the Manila court will soon issue warrants of arrest against the two. In a matter of time, we are just waiting for the issuance of warrant of arrest by the court and after they are considered wanted. So after dismissing the case for insufficiency of evidence, the DOJ suddenly reversed it. What is the relevance of that to what I'm going to reveal to you? I asked the permission of the one who forwarded the text to me from Marcelino. The texts were sent to this other cell phone of mine. Kasi halos hindi ko na ito gagamitin eh. Sisirain ko na ito. Pinipreserve ko lang yung mga messages for whatever purpose it may serve. Okay. Hindi ibig sabihin, don't take it literally. Alright. Now, I got messages from a common acquaintance, you know, for his protection. I cannot reveal who he is. But I got two messages from my source forwarding. So it's really forwarding. Messages from Lieutenant Colonel Marcelino. The first one was received by our common acquaintance July 19, 2016. The second one, fairly recent, was received September 5, 2016. Messages lang ito na fin-norward ng aking source from Lieutenant Colonel Marcelino. Ang laman po, ganito. This is verbatim. A message I got from Lieutenant Colonel Marcelino. This is the July 19, 2016 message. Mista, good PM. Magpasalamat lang sana ako sa lahat ng tulong at efforts mo for me habang ako ay nasa kulungan. I can never thank you enough, Mista. Hindi pa ako masyado makagalaw at labas ngayon dahil ang dami gusto kumatay sa akin book. Di ko pa din mapuntahan si Senator LD, obviously referring to me, Leila de Lima, LD, kasi tinagawan kami ng mga fabricated stories. There are also some groups who is trying to convince me to speak against her. But rest assured, na hindi ako pagagamit sa kanila, Mista. Not only because I really appreciated and forever indebted sa inyo ni ma'am, but because the people deserve no less than the truth and justice. With my little knowledge and brief encounter with her, I never doubted whatsoever her integrity, Mista. Magpasalamat din sana ako sa kanya personally when everything settles down. Ingat lagi, And maraming salamat uli, Ms. Ta. That was July 19. The more recent message, a shorter one, na pinorward ulit sa akin ng source ko, September 5, 2016. So the message from my source, I got a message from Lieutenant Colonel Marcelino, quote, "Ms. Ta, pressures against me are mounting, and they would even reopen my case. But rest assured that I will never give in to them, Ms. Ta. Please tell Senator L to keep faith and be strong." I want people to know that these things are happening now. Meron pa rin iba akong mga ibang alam. Hindi lang ako nakakakuha pa ng clearance from them kung pwede ko na rin i-disclose sa inyo. Through our common acquaintance kanina, nung nabasa ko nga po itong media report na ito, when I woke up this morning, na-reverse na yung kaso against Colonel Marcelino, I immediately texted our common acquaintance and asked him, "Can I seek the permission of Colonel Marcelino to disclose what he texted to me or what he forwarded through you to me, his messages?" And sumagot naman yung common acquaintance namin na pwede daw. Although out of reach by anyone ngayon siya, apparently because siguro nalaman na niya to na mag-i-issue na sila ng warrants of arrest, he is secretly, privately communicating with me po. That's the situation now.